Hey, folks, and welcome back to Glenn and Adrian's Rock Talk. That's Adrian.
And that's Glenn.
And today, we're going to return to ELP for a look at Carnival 9 Live. And it's not the entire piece, but it is the most popular parts of it, I believe. It's going to be First Impression Part 2, and then the Third Impression. So it's going to equal about 19 minutes or so. Now, I've never seen them actually do this song before, but I look forward to that. Also worth noting is Pete Sinfield is the lyricist, at least on the Third Impression. He just passed away last week, I believe, and he was, of course, the guy that wrote the lyrics for The Court of the Crimson King, that whole album, and did plenty of other work, actually.
Probably one of my favorite lyricists, too. It's just something, there's some style to, you know, what he does.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, he wasn't just a lyricist, either. He was actually a musician, and he even had a solo album. It'd be interesting to hear his music someday.
Yeah.
See what it sounds like.
He was also, he also did the light shows for King Crimson.
Okay. Very good.
That was his other role in King Crimson.
But we have been looking over the whole legacy of Emerson, Lake, and Palmer. We just did separate videos to tributize both Keith Emerson and Greg Lake. So if you haven't seen those, take a look for them. This particular concert was the California Jam 1974. This is another one of those events that's basically a festival situation. They have multiple bands on, there's a huge crowd, you know, everybody wins, theoretically. So, so this, of course, would have been during their tour, right after Brain Salad Surgery came out. Definitely looking forward to it. So we have Keith Emerson, Hammond organs, Moog and Mini Moog synthesizers, and a ring-modulated computer voice. So I bet we can figure out what that is. And then, of course, we have Greg Lake, vocals, guitar, bass, and chewing gum, apparently. And it says Carl Palmer, drums, percussion, and gongs. So, Adrian, you haven't seen this before, is that correct?
No, I haven't.
Good. Okay. Let's go ahead and check this out.
All right.
Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. So glad you could attend. Come inside, come inside. There behind the glass stars a real blade of grass. Be careful as you pass. Move along, move along. Come inside, the show's about to start. Guaranteed to blow your head apart. Rest assured, you'll get your money's worth. Greatest show in heaven, hell, or earth. You gotta see the show. It's a dynamo. You gotta see the show. It's rock and roll.
Thank you.
Thrust into the face of the night. Cause a blade of compassion kissed by countless skins. True trumpet words by their sight. Wars that no man thought would fall. The altars of the just crushed. Dust in the wind. Thank you. The tapes I've recorded their names. I am all there is. But I give you life to do what was right.
Something.
Yeah, a stellar performance of a masterpiece. A couple of things I noticed was that the third impression was played in a much lower key. I think they dropped it like a major third or even a fourth.
Wow.
Maybe a much higher key on the record. Anyway.
Interesting. Yeah, maybe they realized it was just too much for live.
It's possible. I don't know. But also, this is the first time I've ever heard a drum solo from the great Carl Palmer.
Oh, yeah?
He's got to be. He's definitely one of the greatest drummers in rock and roll, in my opinion.
Yeah, I would say even just based on that one solo, I would agree with you.
Yeah.
Oh, that was funny. Yeah, did you notice a few things about that solo? Like the bell.
Yeah, gongs. The bell, yeah, he was ringing it with his teeth. He had a string going down to his mouth, and he was ringing it with his teeth, man.
Yeah. That's dedication.
Yeah,
that's pretty amazing. I don't remember anybody else doing, using their teeth as part of their drum kit,
session. Yeah.
And so
I've heard of it with guitars, but not with a drum kit.
That's hilarious, though. Yeah, let me see. Things that I noted. Emerson, in that first part, the very first part of the video that they were playing, it looked like he was using one of the mini Moogs just as a bass instrument. He had it toned down, and then Lake was over there on electric guitar.
Yeah.
For that. So he was handling the bass. It was kind of like the Ray Manzarek, like of the Doors. He's got the bass over here, and then he's on the Hammond over on the other side, and like very snazzy,
Yeah. Keith Emerson can do that, and that's amazing.
Yeah, for sure. Did you catch the huge patch bay over the synthesizer, which I think was on top
of the Hammond? Oh, I think I saw it. Yeah, that was Hammond. Huge, man. Bigger than an ARP synthesizer that I remember seeing.
Yeah, old technology. And it looked like they had that thing that it looked like an oscilloscope, but maybe used for something else on the top there. Yeah. That's the thing they kept going back to. So maybe, Adrian, how familiar are you with the lyrics in Carnival 9? Can you explain the storyline?
It seems to be a story about a struggle between man and computer for world domination. At least that's the third impression. What I get from the first impression is that it's kind of like a futuristic circus show or something like that.
Okay. Yep. Okay. Yeah.
I don't get the entire point of the song, but I don't care. It's great. It's a great piece of music.
Yeah, it's funny. You kept saying "roll up," and I just kept thinking of the Magical Mystery Tour. You know, but yeah. I guess it was a common thing to say at carnivals or something. You know.
Yeah,
I don't know. So and how about that part at the end where they're. You know, suddenly there's all this big pink smoke coming out of the keyboard rack, you know, the whole keyboard stand there. Like I'm looking at it going, I hope he's not still in there. And I don't think he was. I think he'd left, but
yeah. You
know, they were just using a sequencer for the end part. So
yeah, I remember that. I remember the smoke. they extended that sequencer part too in the end.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
That's good to know. Yeah, this is one piece I am not very familiar with. I have to listen to the album. Really, I'm not even sure if I've ever sat down once to listen to the whole album before, so I should do that.
Yeah, or not even the whole album, just Carnival 9. It starts at the end of side one, and it goes through all of side two.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, maybe I will endeavor to do that in the near future.
Yeah, you should. It's a great piece of music.
It's like The Last Frontier. Yeah, it's always good, you know, when there are albums that you sort of just didn't pay much attention to back in the day. And it's like, well, now when you're already pretty familiar with the rest of the catalog, you're like, oh, great. Now I can go back. It's like a fresh album.
Hmm.
So I've been able to do that a few, you know.
Yeah, I've done that a few times.
Yeah, it's quite a lot of fun, actually. It's like, yeah. Oh, my. Quite a nice thing to listen to, quite an amazing thing to behold as they were playing it. And of course, all our respects to Pete Sinfield and all the great work he did in the music industry. Yeah, so folks, why don't you let us know what you thought of this performance and how familiar you are with the song. And if you ever saw ELP at all, let us know below. And if you have other suggestions for us, please leave those below. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. And if you enjoyed our presentation, please subscribe. All right. Thanks so much for joining us, and we'll catch you on the next one, all right? Take care, folks.
See you all later.